So let's say you're out and about, you get a stain on your t-shirt, and there's no washing machine in sight. What do you do? Probably pull out your phone and Google some quick stain removal tips. But are any of those tips actually any good? So today on Reactions, we are going to test a few different types of stains. Bacon grease, red wine, and animal blood. So yeah, that is animal blood, but it is food grade. So we got it from a local market here in DC.
We did not get this from an intern or in fact any other human, and we are decked out in the proper safety gear, and we do not recommend, in fact, please don't try this particular demo at home.
For today, we will be using a 100% cotton t-shirt. So keep that in mind because whatever you get a stain on might not be 100% cotton, so these will not necessarily behave in the same way.
Also, they might destroy your shirt.
So that too.
You don't want that.
Yeah.
Well, let's dive right in.
So, red wine. So if George, you could open that up.
Yep.
Then I'm gonna run through a few of the things that Google has told us will help remove it. So first, we've got white wine. Next, we've got isopropyl alcohol or rubbing alcohol and hydrogen peroxide, both of which you'll probably find in your medicine cabinet. Then we've got some table salt, boiling hot water, and our control, cold water. So George, if you could turn on that hot water and let's stain this shirt.
Let's do it. All right, and now we wait 5 minutes for the stain to set.
5 minutes later.
Okay, so should we start with the cold water?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right. So we put 3 drops of stain on 6 spots of this shirt, and we are now gonna put 10 drops of cold water and see what happens.
Oh.
Working?
It's not looking good for you.
Okay, well, cold water, as you would expect, doesn't seem to do much of anything.
No.
All right, what do you want to try next?
Let's try this white wine.
Okay, let's do it.
So 10 drops of white wine, let's see what happens. It's also not great.
Also does not seem to be doing very much. Should we try rubbing alcohol next?
Let's try it. So we've got the isopropyl alcohol, better known as rubbing alcohol. Let's see what this does.
8, 9, 10. I have to say, it looks slightly better than our control.
Just slightly.
But not a lot.
Not a lot.
Not a lot. Let's try hydrogen peroxide.
Let's try it. 10 drops of that.
All right. Yeah, I am... Oh, you know what? Again, slightly better than our control.
Looks like isopropyl alcohol is the best so far.
Okay, let's keep going. We got...
All right, so we've got some salt.
Yes. Let's just dump some out there.
So they say to really cover it on Google tips.
Okay.
And then to just use your finger to rub it in.
More salt, Captain! Seriously, can we have some more salt?
Oh, I'm Captain. Okay, got it, got it, got it. And we'll just put a little bit of water.
Yeah.
Now let's see, is there a difference? No.
No, that almost
that's
looks
like worse.
Yeah, that is really worse.
All right.
What's our last one?
Boiling water.
Boiling water.
Let's
all
try
right.
it out.
That had time to cool, so we'll just let it come up to the boil again.
2 minutes later.
Okay, our water is boiling, so let's give this guy a test here. Hot. I'm going to cover a pipette with paper towel so I don't burn myself. 7, 8. 9, 10. So I think what I'd like to do before we draw any conclusions from this is maybe hit it with some more of our best performer.
All right, so we are gonna go all in on the isopropyl alcohol. Or that. Great. I'm pretty impressed.
Stain is definitely still there. It's not disappeared. This isn't magic.
But it's like a very, very light pink.
Yeah, that's better. That's better than it was before. Should we try the same with boiling water?
Yeah, let's do it.
1 minute later.
I wish the American Chemical Society had elevator music in their elevators.
That's true. We don't have elevator music.
There's
in
nothing
our elevators.
In the elevators.
It's just dead silence.
Huh.
What are we supposed to do in there?
A few seconds later.
We're at a boil. Here we go. Hey, it's already kind of working.
So definitely don't have your shirt on while you do this because it is boiling water.
Yes. Let's keep going. Hey, I think that actually...
That might have just handled it.
That might have taken care of it. Now, we didn't douse everything else in the other stuff.
Yeah.
So there's that.
That's true. We did put quite a bit of
isopropyl alcohol there. Yeah, we put a lot of rubbing alcohol. All right, so this was the wine stain that we added boiling water to. This guy was rubbing alcohol, and it looks like boiling water is the clear winner.
Large amounts of boiling water dissolved that wine stain really well, better than cold water, likely because hot water has more energy, meaning its water molecules are moving more quickly, which could help break up the stain. And warmer water also increases the solubility of substances, so that might help you pick up more wine with boiling water compared to cold.
Yeah. All right, so blood. So the things we're gonna test to try and get blood out of our white cotton t-shirt include meat tenderizer, contact lens solution, hydrogen peroxide, lemon juice, and soap, dish soap. So let's try it and see.
All right, and so just like with the wine, let's go ahead and drop 3 drops. All right, ooh, this is far more viscous.
Okay, so now we wait for 5 minutes to let the stain set.
5 minutes later.
These are pretty intense.
Yeah, these look hard to get out.
Yes. So we'll start with the cold water control.
Yes.
Well.
Oh, hey. It's a little unexpected. It's kind of wicking away the blood.
Oh. Weird.
It's coming out.
Yeah. I mean, I'm actually really surprised. Mm. I thought there was no way that it was going to get almost any out.
Yeah. And show the napkin. I mean, that's clearly...
It's definitely getting some blood out.
That's clearly coming out. Well, let's move on to the next thing. What would you like to try?
I want to try the lemon juice. I'm very curious about that. Oh.
That looks darker.
Definitely darker. Yeah, this looks so dark. Yeah, well...
It's really different. Well, let's... I don't know. Let's get after it.
See what happens.
See what happens. Yeah. Yeah, that looks... mud brown, I guess you would say. Probably not something you want to do to your shirt if
you get
blood on it.
I'd avoid that.
Yeah. All right.
Interesting.
Next up.
Let's try that contact solution. 10. I mean, it's definitely got out some blood, but the water still seems a bit better.
Yeah.
Similar. Pretty similar.
Yeah, roughly the same.
The lemon is really bad.
The lemon is bad. Let's see. I'm going to start with the bubbles.
Cool.
Do hydrogen peroxide.
Awesome.
All right.
Whoa.
There we go.
Look at that fizz.
That is decomposing the hydrogen peroxide into oxygen and water. All right. Let's see.
Whoa. Okay, so it still looks kind of gross, but it seems promising.
Yeah, because that is maybe the best one so far.
Yeah.
All right, so let's do soap. Now, 10 drops of dish soap seems like it would be excessive given that you need 1 drop to wash an entire cast iron skillet. Now, you would never wash cast iron with dish soap. That's a terrible idea. Don't do that.
Watch our how to wash a,
we do have a video
cast iron skillet. Yeah, I know. Right, so we'll rub it in, and then I think the idea is to then also add some water.
Because without water, there's not much is happening here, except smearing the blood around a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So let's add some water and see what happens. Go for it.
Ah. All right. So definitely dish soap and hydrogen peroxide are in the lead by far.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, let's finish off with meat tenderizer. Would you hit me with a few drops?
Mm-hmm. That looks really bad.
Yep, this is not good. This is not good. All right, should we revisit our 2 best performers?
All right, hydrogen peroxide. Even better.
Yeah, look at that.
Wow, that's really good.
I have to say, I'm somewhat surprised. I didn't expect it to get rid of so much of the color.
Yeah.
Shall we revisit the dish soap?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay, let's add some more of that. Hey.
Also not bad.
Yeah, also pretty good. So I think we can call this one, I would say, what, tie between the hydrogen peroxide, slight edge to hydrogen peroxide over dish soap?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right, let's call it.
Hydrogen peroxide.
We just called it.
we did.
So when we poured hydrogen peroxide on that blood stain, it was broken down by catalase, an enzyme found in our blood. So catalase is actually super important in our bodies because it keeps dangerous reactive oxygen species created by oxidizers like hydrogen peroxide from forming. Catalase converts hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen, and that release of oxygen creates the fizzing you see on the shirt. That reactive oxygen species, though, was probably responsible for oxidizing the pigments in the blood stain, which changed them from red to less red.
So we've got our bacon grease, and for this one we are testing, what would you call this, a grab bag of internet lore?
Yeah, I think that's an accurate description. Yeah. So my the ones I'm most intrigued to see how they work are hairspray and cola. But then we also have baking soda, we've got some baby powder, and of course dish soap, which I think is most likely to work.
Yeah, I think the dish soap is going to be the clear winner here. But there is only one way to find out. We're gonna get our bacon grease on the shirt here, and now we wait.
One awkward silence later.
Do you sing like with a group?
No, just alone in the shower.
Okay.
I wonder what color this is.
I mean, I put it on my head right before this.
Oh, so is it clear?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, what do you think, hairspray? Well, do you think it's a color?
That was a mistake.
It's holding. It's great, like a weird little.
That was also a mistake. Okay, 5 minutes are up. Control first?
Yeah, control first, always. All right, so we're gonna let this dry a bit because at first glance, it looks like it could be out.
Yeah.
But we'll see. I'm so excited to try this one.
You know, I guess 10 drops wouldn't be as brown as, oh, nope, that's exactly as brown as you think it'll be.
All right. Well, we'll see what it looks like when it dries. Let's do some baking soda.
Okay, so now you're doing baking soda.
This is baking soda.
That's
all right.
Pretty good, actually.
This is not bad. Yeah. I mean, yeah, we'll see.
All right,
moving
well,
on.
Let's try baby powder.
Yeah. Oh, it's like coating it.
Yeah, it's like a
thick layer.
Cakiness.
I feel like you could just, with your nail, just peel it.
Oh, yeah, look at that. It is kind of coming off. All right, so we'll do dish soap next.
A little dish soap,
and
rub it in,
water.
And then a bit of water.
Yeah, let me grab some water from you.
Oh, that's good.
That one is good. Might have an outright winner here.
Hey, George, don't discount the hairspray.
Sorry, you're right, Haven't even tested the hairspray yet. Yeah.
All
okay,
right.
The pièce de résistance.
Actually, be too bad.
Yeah.
We gotta let it dry a little.
So we are gonna let this sit for about 10 minutes and come back and see what happens.
A dry t-shirt later.
All right, so we took a space heater to this shirt for about 10 minutes. Our control, we have got a classic grease stain.
Yeah.
It looks, honestly, it looks just like a water spot, but it's dry, and that is grease. Cola. Exactly what you would expect.
Not only do we still have a grease stain, but there's also a dark ring around it.
Yeah.
So don't do that.
Yeah, not sure why Google suggested that.
Nope.
This guy is baking soda, right?
Yes.
Okay, and
here... It's not quite as bad as if you just used water, but it's still not great.
Yeah, you can still see that. That's noticeable.
Yeah. Yep.
Same deal for the baby powder. That's still
it's
a grease stain.
Yeah,
that's still a grease stain. Here we've got dish soap and water, and I think, yeah, that's the winner so far. And I think, what, second place?
Second place actually goes to hairspray.
Surprisingly.
Except the shirt is incredibly crunchy.
Yeah.
So I would say absolutely dish soap and water.
Dish soap and water.
Clear winner.
Clear winner.
Dish soap is a surfactant. Surfactants have a water-soluble head and an oil-soluble tail. That allows them to form a spherical structure around droplets of oil or grease, removing it from a surface, like our white cotton t-shirt.
But let's review what we found. So We'll start with blood. What was the best there?
For blood, we found that the hydrogen peroxide treatment and then also the dish soap and water seemed to be by far the best option. And for those, again, we really added as much as we possibly could.
Right. The 10 drops was not going to do it in that case.
Yeah.
And lemon juice was
really
terrible for blood. That was not good.
Yeah.
All right. Wine.
So for wine, I was shocked to see actually that the boiling water was what did it. So as we were pouring it, you could just see the wine, I don't know if dissipating
disappear.
Is the right word, but disappear.
Yeah.
But again, not while you have the shirt on. Do not pour scalding hot water on yourself.
Right.
Yeah.
All right, what about bacon? Bacon grease, not just a big slab of bacon on your shirt.
The best was dish soap and water.
Yep.
But surprisingly, the hairspray actually did pretty well.
Yeah, came in second. Again,
yeah.
Like not a close second, I would say.
Yeah.
But still second.
Yeah, still second, but it did give you a bit of a crunchy shirt.
It did,
The downside. We only had so much time to go over Google stain removal tips. So if there are other ones that you think are great, let us know in the comments and we'll
see
you
next
week.
One freeze frame later. Please do not be weird in the comments.